the script's based on Nick Spark's novel, The Best of Me. And I suppose what drew me to the story was this, you know, the hook of the novel is, I'm going to ask the question, was that first person you really fell in love with, was that the person? Was that the person you should have been with? So it follows a relationship between two people, Dawson and Amanda, from the time they meet each other when they're 17, 18. And then it jumps 20 years ahead to when they're both 40, and they're brought together again at the funeral of a mutual friend, and they meet each other again, and neither one of them have ever really gotten over the relationship, and it's about that, and I think it plays into that question we do all ask ourselves about whether or not that first one was the one. Nick Sparks is a writer who, he really has a, there's a system to his work. I mean, don't get me wrong when I say it, you know, like Shakespeare. But it, when in Shakespeare, you see the same kinds of characters appear in a number of stories, but they take slightly different roles and there's slightly different permutations. And so, you know, like The Notebook, it is a story about a rich girl and a poor boy. And like many of his books, there's a wise old man figure, you know, who's played brilliantly. His character talks played brilliantly by Gerald McRaney. But from that point, it really diverges in terms of being a real investigation of this question I mentioned before, this question about, you know, the first love, and could that person that moved me so much back then, who I first felt this deep, deep connection with, did I miss an opportunity there? Did I miss the possibility of real love that maybe I never found again? Dawson's kind of raised by wolves. His family, the Coles, are, you know, a pretty notorious bunch of meth dealers, and you can imagine they've been in this area for generations. Probably they were moonshiners at one point. They moved over into the drug trade, and they also want to keep their tribe together. So when Dawson, who's a bright kid, and senses a kind of future for himself outside of the family, tries to emerge from it, they do everything they can to suppress that and hold him back. And the character of Amanda, I mean, what's so great about her is she is this completely bold, empowering female energy who finds him and says, you can do it. You can be whatever you want to be. You can be the best of yourself. Amanda, as a young woman, is really, really lively and really certain of herself and really, you know, quite bold and out there. And when we see her, you know, 20 years on, she's very shut down, and she's become quite kind of cold, and this marriage she's in really hasn't worked. And although she's a very good mother, there's a way in which she feels cut off. And when she sees Dawson again, her first response is really to protect herself and not let herself be vulnerable again. So the same time, I mean, we need to love the character and connect to her. So, you know, Michelle's challenge was to bring that, make sure that humanity was always bubbling around underneath all that reserve that she's generated. So, and I think she did a wonderful job of that. I think there'll be real satisfaction from a kind of just emotional truthfulness in the performances, and a story that's easy, you know, it's a story about love, and that makes it relatively easy to relate to.